Hello, I'm Mike, and in this video, I'm going to create a version of Perplexity using vibe coding. It'll go out, search the web, browse websites, and then come back to me with the ultimate answers to my questions. To do this, we're going to be using Lovable today, and in true vibe coding style, I'll speak to Lovable. I'd like you to create a web app called Find It AI. The purpose is to answer a user's question. What you'll do is send that question via a webhook to a webhook that I define in .env, and that then will go out and search the web and browse websites to present a final answer, which will come back to you also via a webhook to the app. Once you receive the callback from the webhook, you'll present the answer to the user's questions. Okay, look at that lovely initial prompt. It's all ready to go. Let's see what Lovable makes. You can see straight away it's creating Find It AI, it's thinking, it's writing all the index files that are needed, and it will spin up my preview over here very soon. Okay, that's awesome. It looks like it's spinning up my website, and here it is. Find It AI, ask any question and let AI search the web, browse websites and provide comprehensive answers. Very, very cool stuff indeed. So before I ask a question, I can see my app has actually given me the ability to configure my webhook. Now this is very comprehensive because it's asking for a webhook URL and it's also giving expected request and response formats. I think this app is pretty much ready to deploy and test. Obviously we need to get the search and web browsing ability in there, but we'll do that soon. Let's deploy this app. I'll click publish, and you can see I can actually host it on Lovable or I can use a custom domain. I'm just going to change this name a little bit and we'll just call it Find It AI. There we go. That's pretty easy. Publish. And there we go. You just shipped in just one prompt and literally a minute. I've built a mini website. So let's visit, and here we go. It's loading up exactly as it was presented to me inside Lovable. Now I can configure everything here and get it to call back to this URL up here. So now we need to build the back end of our app, an AI agent that will search the web, browse websites, and bring its findings to me, the end user of the app. And to do that, I'm actually going to use Zapier agents because they're really cool and you'll see exactly how they work. I would like you to receive webhook data and then search Google and search the web for answers before finally presenting your results to another webhook. That's my initial prompt. It's really, really easy. But before I go ahead and create the agent, let's actually go back to my app here and we'll copy this webhook configuration detail as it's super, super helpful. And we'll also paste that into the configuration of my Zapier agent and create. And look at this, AI search answer deliverer, it's called. Let's call it Find It Backend, like so. Okay, so this is an agent I've just created, and you can see the better I present my prompt, the better I get. When a post request is received at a specific URL, extract the question and callback URL from the incoming data, use the extracted question to perform a search on Google. Now, this is great because I can actually insert a tool, and you'll see here in Zapier Agents, you can choose visit a website or do a Google search. Yes, that's right, my agent can do a Google search. Then it will use the extracted question to perform a general web search. And again, we just insert a tool, visit website, like so. Compile the results from the Google and web searches into a comprehensive answer and list of sources. Then make a JSON object, this is very comprehensive, and send it to a callback URL extracted from the initial data. Now, if we look at the settings of this, you'll see I let my agent decide the value for every single field here. So I'm truly letting this process behind the scenes be totally agentic. And the expected outcome is that the AI's answer and source information are successfully delivered to the specified callback URL. Sounds fantastic. Well, do you know what? I'm not going to do anything else with this. We can see it's ready to catch a hook and it gives me my Zapier webhook URL that I'll need. So we copy that and save it. And then we just switch this on. And it really was as simple as that. I created my Zapier agent that will go out and search Google, search the web, and present answers back to my web app. That's pretty cool, right? So now back in Find It AI, my little app I've made, all I need to do is paste that Zapier webhook URL in here. I've already presented this expected request format and response format, so we'll just save the configuration. And now, well, I guess I can ask my first question. Find out everything you can about Creator Magic and Mike Russell and his connections to artificial intelligence. Well, there is the first question. Let's search with AI and see what happens. Okay, I wish that had worked on the first attempt, but you can see here there's an error. It failed to send to the service. And if I right click and go to inspect, we can look over here in console and we can see some errors here. Well, I can simply copy and paste them into Lovable and see if we can get it fixed. So we'll just say here, fix error, and paste in the console error there. And look at this, Lovable sees the error. It's a cross-origin resource sharing error. I should have known that. Anyway, it's rewriting the index, and soon we'll be able to search with AI. Okay, it seems to have fixed it, so I'll just click publish, and again, I can instantly update and redeploy my app. Now we've refreshed the app and we'll look, yep, the webhook is still there and configured, so we'll make sure that's saved. And now we'll paste in my question again to find out everything about Creator Magic and Mike Russell and see if Search with AI actually works. And look at this, question sent successfully. AI is analyzing my question. Now if we look at my Zapier agent, you can actually see it's starting to search Google for information about Creator Magic, Mike Russell, and connection to artificial intelligence. Wow, okay, it's done a Google search. Look at this, it's found all of this information about me and Creator Magic. It's now browsing websites for me, which is pretty insane. It's looking at my Creator Magic membership community and browsing my profile. The web browsing is complete. What's really cool about this is it gets a screenshot. You can see there I am in my own community. Okay, it's thinking about what to do next and it's compiling its answer and calling back the webhook to my Find It AI app. Okay, this is really good news. It seems to have posted back to my webhook. So let's check the app and see what's happened. And over here, look at this. I've just received an answer, the comprehensive answer to my question. Researching about Creator Magic and Mike Russell, connections to AI. I'm the founder of Creator Magic, a platform dedicated to empowering individuals to build AI-powered applications without code. This is very good. Yes, we can see Mike demonstrates how to use tools like Replic, Cursor, and Lovable, I might add as well, can be used to design, develop, and deploy sophisticated AI applications. I'm an AI educator. This is all very good. I'm on YouTube, LinkedIn, X. Wow. And look at all these sources here. So if I actually click to visit, yep, here is my profile on the Creator Magic community. This is the YouTube link. That seems to work really well. This is my LinkedIn, my X profile, and even a podcast I've been on, The Creator's Guide to AI Wizardry. Yep, that's very good. That is a podcast I did indeed appear on. Wow, I am impressed. With a combination of Lovable and Zapier agents, I can really do thorough research on anyone, anything, or any question I have by spinning an app up in minutes that can do the work for me. We've used clever Zapier agent abilities such as a Google search and visiting websites before posting back to a webhook at my app that was created over here in Lovable using just one simple prompt and a few updates to get exactly what I wanted. Now, just to make sure that wasn't a fluke, I'm going to ask it one more question. What is AI orchestration? And we'll search with AI. Oh, and while that search is going, it's a good time to tell you that Zapier is actually the most connected AI orchestration platform out there, ready for you to build something amazing with using AI agents. Again, you'll see it's going to work. It's Google searching, it's web browsing to find out all about AI orchestration, and it's preparing to send the compiled answer back to my app inside Lovable. And here we can see it's done it. It's called my API callback with a comprehensive answer. Let's check the app. And my Zapier AI agent has gone, done the research, and given a comprehensive answer. It is indeed the coordination and management of artificial intelligence models, systems, and integrations. It goes on to give a more comprehensive answer there, and it sources stuff from IBM, Hatchworks, Pure Storage, and other websites as well, which I can open up. And I'm loving the orchestra graphic, very appropriate for the subject matter. So there you go, you can see in a matter of minutes, I built a web app that can basically replace the functionality of Perplexity using my own Zapier agent that I built, and of course the web app and front end that I created inside Lovable. Just showing you how easy it is to vibe code your own apps these days. Lovable, I would say, is probably the easiest way right now to make something that's in your mind and get it published online as quickly as possible. And when you're ready to graduate and learn more about AI coding, development, and using AI tools to make something amazing, come and join my Creator Magic Premium community for more. It's the place where hundreds of builders are creating something amazing, many success stories, and a great way to get started on your AI creation journey. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope you've enjoyed it. Let me know what app you're inspired to create now as a result of watching this video. Leave a comment down below with your thoughts, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next.